Hi, Simon. Thank you for taking part in what I hope is going to be a relatively informal chat today. For those that don't know, I thought it would be good if you could give a bit of an elevator pitch in terms of what Simarco is all about and where you operate, if that's okay.
Essentially, we're a leading independent freight and logistics company. We've got seven strategic locations across the UK, from north to south. We're IT-led and we provide freight and logistics solutions for exporters and importers.
Yeah, fantastic. Thank you. And I guess given what we've just gone through over the last 3 or 4 months or so, yeah, it only feels right to start this sort of chat by saying, you know, how are you at the moment? How does everything feel? And what has your experience been over the last 2 or 3 months?
I mean, we put our heads together and we came up with a plan. Really what we were looking at is saying, right, suddenly our revenues have dropped below 50%. And oh my God, we've got warehouses, staff, overheads. You know, how long can we sustain? I think the conversation was, how many months could we go on at 50% of revenue with all of these overheads? Well, you know, fortunately, we spoke to suppliers and suppliers extended credit. The furlough scheme was obviously a major factor. I think we furloughed about 120 staff at the time, so that was really important. And then there was the VAT. There was the VAT holiday. I don't know if it was a holiday, but there was a deferment of payment for that. So that just eased our cash flow. And unfortunately, there were a couple of businesses which we could not, we saw just weren't going to recover. They shut down completely. So that forced us to make a few redundancies or some redundancies, which was unfortunate. But I think if you looked across our industry, that was fairly common with companies our size.
And when you think about that and sort of key learnings that are coming out of this, what do you think you will sort of carry on and take forward into, you know, whatever will be the new normal in, you know, going forwards?
Well, there's two or three things that happened. Well, obviously it's accelerated change. So where, I don't know if we dithered, that's the wrong word, but where there was maybe some prejudice against home working, you know, as an idea, you know, you need to be in the office, you know, you need to be here because there's certain things you need to do. I think that's all gone out the window. And actually, because this, I've said this, this is my biggest saying, necessity is the mother of invention, but it is. And therefore, people have to, you know, because people had to work at home, and oh, hang on, he or she is working from home and it's made no difference to their productivity. In fact, it's improved their productivity and they're looking quite well with it. And actually, isn't that a good idea? So let's embrace that. So in that sense, administration job, accounts jobs, warehouse and IT and some logistics jobs, they can happen remotely. And then obviously the other thing is accelerated integration in our business. So where we had situations with where we possibly hadn't integrated certain sectors of the business with the IT, we just we've rushed all of that together. Boom, it's all happened really quickly. So what would have taken a year has taken 3 months.
Fantastic. Well, like you say, necessity for change really, really drives it, doesn't it? So in many ways, taking the positives out of a trying situation is a good thing, really. And with lockdown measures now beginning to lift, how do you feel about the next sort of 6 to 12 months?
Over the next 6 to 12 months, the final quarter of this year will be important because there'll be the pre-Brexit clear out, as I call it. So we're going to see, I think we're going to see really, and I hope politicians don't quote this as the economy picking up. This is going to be a big sort of rush to get goods out of the country before the administration and the extra costs start coming in. So I see this year being crazy last quarter, and then next year a really flat, subdued first quarter. And obviously the concern about coronavirus and the problems with the end of the furlough scheme, how many companies are going to stay solvent, what's the market going to look like, and Brexit piled on top of that, those things are a concern, but you know, we've got a really good management team and a really good bunch of people, and I think we're quite agile. Even we're a small big company.
Yeah, I hear lots of people talking about agility being the key to success. So
yeah,
I think that's, you know, really positive message. And one final question from me, and a question we've been asking, you know, business leaders like yourselves throughout this period is, how would you like to be remembered as having led through this crisis? And what are, you know, do you think are the key learnings for yourself and the team going forwards?
Well, I think really the management team. So we, how would we like to be remembered rather than me? But the management team, I think we would like to be remembered one of the things RFD said is that the way we treat our suppliers now, that will forge our relationships with suppliers. So we took the opportunity to sort of really be to engage with them, talk to them, write to them, and really bring them on board, and not sort of say, well, okay, well, everyone's in trouble, we're just not going to pay you. That wasn't the way. And I think what that's done is that's really stood us in really good stead with these people, with the suppliers. Same with customers. If you're pulling out the stops for the customers, which is, you know, we're only here because of the customers. If we don't have customers, we don't have a business. So we pull out the stops for them. And then communicating with the staff, we talked about that. But actually, bringing them on board. I've used this thing because I don't really like the word customer when I talk to customers. I always think the best customers are the ones you have a partnership with. We call it partnerships, but that is it. You're saying, listen, I'm charging you, I'm making money out of what I'm doing, you're hopefully taking a benefit about the service I'm giving you, but that's a partnership. You know, we're working together, and we should talk openly about these things. And I think what that's done is it's made our partnership stronger.
Yeah.
The group of people that always keep everything going, and whilst we're, and I love our office staff, and I love people at the management and so on, but it's warehouse and drivers. And I always say this to everyone, whatever you've got on your table, whether it's this cup or this iPhone or whatever it is, that has been handled by a warehouse and delivered by a driver. And our drivers during that crisis, as I say, delivered goods every day. And on top of that, in their own time, okay, they were using our vehicles, but in their own time, free of charge, work delivering PPE and beds to the NHS. And that kind of shows you, and it's not the first time those guys are doing that. They're always doing it. And so I just go back to that no matter what we do and how many bar charts we get and graphs and spreadsheets, in the end, it's those warehouse and drivers that make it happen. Without them, no one's got a business.
No, I think you're absolutely right. We certainly owe a debt of gratitude to so many people across different sectors.
Yes.
And you know, your point around acting as a business with integrity, you know, those real sort of open, transparent conversations with staff, suppliers, customers, it all adds to the brand and, like you say, that partnership and really delivers, you know, the strength, not only in terms of financial performance, but you know, that vision around where you want to drive the business going forward. So, you know, I couldn't agree more with what you're saying. So, you know, fantastic and well done. Yeah. Thank you so much for your time today. It's been a real pleasure speaking to you, and I look forward to speaking to you again soon.
Thanks, Doug. Thank you. Cheers.